Okay, I'm going to show you how to make a tileable background, meaning it repeats along the X and Y axis. So say I have some sort of texture, like right here I have this paper texture, and I don't want to use the whole thing. I just want to take a square's worth of paper. Well, I can certainly do that. I'm going to hold down Shift as I drag out. Sometimes I like to work with squares. It doesn't really matter in the scheme of things, and you'll see why. I want to plan a little bit though. I know that this area right here is a bit darker, so I kind of want to avoid that. Same thing with the other side. I don't want to get right in the middle. So I'm going to copy that. I'm actually going to close this because I have a bunch of things on there I don't need. Make a new image and then paste that in. So here I have this square. Now the first thing I want to do is get rid of any outstanding marks like that little dot. I'm going to use the clone tool, so I hold down Alt, click, and then I can click around it and kind of get rid of that. That's just because things that are kind of outstanding like that tend to show up, of course, naturally, because you're repeating, so it is a bit more noticeable that you have a repeating background that's kind of small. The first thing to keep in mind is I do have this on a separate layer right there, and that's very important because I'm going to start cutting at this thing. I'm actually going to grab about half of it. I'm going to say Control or Command X, and I'm going to move this over. And then I'm going to paste. Now the reason I do that is because we already know that, just to back up for a second here, that middle part looks just fine. What I'm actually going to do then is move these things to opposite sides. Now with some patterns, you'll notice the seam a bit more. It's not really visible in this, but say there was a seam there, I wanted to get rid of that. I would then merge those two layers so I have the solid square again, and then I would use a little bit of the clone tool, and I would set the brush to be one of the blurry brushes, or fuzzy brushes if you like, and then kind of move over the middle there, kind of covering up that seam area. We can even test that by moving this over, duplicating the layer, and then we can place that right there, and we see that it would tile just fine. That's just kind of a testing mechanism, but we already know that it's going to work because I'm telling you it will work. Now, you want to do the same thing to the top and bottom. Because we know that this is going to tile just fine along the x-axis, we want to grab half of this, Command or Control X, depending on if you're using Mac or PC, move it up, Command or Control V to paste. Now here you can see the line a little bit more. So I'm going to do Command or Control E, which merges the layer from the one that you have selected to the bottom one, in case you didn't know. Then I'm going to take the clone tool, hold down Alt, and kind of get rid of that seam. Sometimes you'll notice I move this up and down. That's basically just because I want to get a little bit more variation in that center. It's not critical, but certainly something worth noticing. So now, honestly, this is just fine and ready to go. If I were to save this out now, it will tile, and I'll show you that in just a second. And now I'm going to switch over to Dreamweaver, and I'm going to tile that background so you can see what it looks like. Okay, so I have Dreamweaver open. Now I'm going to go into my style sheet, and I'm going to type in what I need. As I click away, then you can see we have this tiling through the X and Y axis, and it works just fine. Now, you may run across where you just want something to tile along the X or Y axis. In that case, you don't have to do both aspects of that. The first portion of that tutorial, you could just do whichever one you needed along the X or along the Y. That's it.